I guess with me when I teach, I look at the child first. I don't just give them what I think it will be good for them. I try and unveil whatever that they want to say to the world. So if you give a child the opportunity to express themselves, let them say whatever they want to say in their own language and guide them towards that language. So if maybe you see that this kid, let's say maybe you find a kid from the township, they are not really equipped, right, first with materials and stuff. You look at the environment and what they can use in the environment to say what they want to say better. Then you guide them to use that to say whatever they want to say. So that's where I come from. Like, if you go to a place, I look at where you come from, what you want to say, and what we can use to say what you want to say better. So that's, they are different. There is no specific way of of teaching that child. So I go with that child. So if that child maybe is really, and let's say maybe the child wants to make sculptures, but they don't have materials, we look at what he can use, maybe his surroundings, he have cans or whatever that he can find. He can take those fine objects and make a sculpture, but we can guide him to make that sculpture. Pencils and stuff, those are materials that you need to buy, and in most cases, it's difficult for kids from previously disadvantaged communities to have access of those mediums. So we try and bring ways of releasing their creativity without them using those materials. So it's more like recyclable materials to create art. So I think it's mostly advisable to do that in my way, in my own space, and when I teach, I try and bring those materials for them to even access those materials when I'm not there, to have some kind of accessibility to them, because those are the materials that they see every day.